Age of Rivals on the PC. Well, I got my first win in my last video, so I felt good about myself for doing that. It was nip and tuck, but I got the satisfaction of doing that. My campaign, or at least my overall missions, require, what is this, reward coins. I'll replace one of these. Yeah, might as well replace these. Actually, let me see what that does. I'm just curious how that works. I'm gonna have to replace that. I'll just replace it.
This is once a day, man.
Fine. Daily challenges. Not interested in that. Be part one of the campaign, earn this card. Be part two of the campaign. So attempts to find a successor. Well, I won't do that yet. I'm ready for a challenge. Okay. Wait. Oh, so I thought I've already done hard mode? Well, let's see if I can do hard mode later. Anyway, let's play. Versus anyone. Multiplayer games only available online. Okay. No, I'm canceling that. Alright, so that's fine. Challenge. Okay, let's do the campaign then, why not? No, I'm not ready. We'll get to that later, don't worry. Let's practice against a hard opponent. Play versus the computer. On hard difficulty. Oh, I can choose who I want to play against. Okay. I can beat Ziana, second chance, right? I beat her before. I can do it again. We've done it before. We can do it again. I believe the song goes. Okay. Resources? Yeah, well, that's my first resource. So let's grab that. As soon as we can. He grabbed wood. I grabbed horses. Make all the jokes you want about wood and horses. Theater, sanctuary, where I can grab another stone. Ooh. Well, I'll see. Oh, he doesn't have any resources down here. Okay, so I can grab that. I didn't want to lose a resource to him, so I just wanted to grab a resource as soon as I could. But he didn't have any resources down there. Okay, so he's got some resources he can grab. Let me see what I can grab. Gems or iron? Well, they both cost the same. Which one do I want? Well, which one does he not have? He has training, so I guess I'll just grab whatever. Yeah, if he grabs training, I'm not going to be able to train my guys as easily. That sucks. Good for civic. Okay, so we'll grab iron for infantry. So he'll grab training, probably. Yep, of course he grabbed training. So that means all the stuff I want to buy is going to... You don't have to pay a tax. See, I got to pay a tax on that. But... Yeah, at least you get a discount on this. Gambling hall sounds great. Gain 3 whenever you have exactly 1. That's too specific. So I'll grab this. And get the culture with it. And get the money that comes with it, which might be nice. Okay, Northern Trade. Sounds great. Okay, we got... So he can grab that, the learning. So I can grab stone and... Okay, so this will keep me from having to pay taxes on any more of these. So that might be worth it. And I already have a horse here, so I'll just grab these two. So I'll grab the stone and the training. So we get all that. I think I hit my mic there. Give me a second. Okay, what's next? Get a lot of culture here, where I can get learning. Actually, did he grab learning? Yeah, he didn't grab learning yet. Okay. So I could grab that resource. Or I can grab an attacker. I'll probably get some... I got so much culture here. I'll just grab the resources, because I'm not going to get any more in the next turn. After this round, I'm not going to get any more resources, so I might as well just grab them now. So he's almost caught up to me in terms of resources. Actually, he is caught up to me in terms of resources. See? I can grab this again. So I'll get the arts and an extra one of these. That might be nice. See, I already have 2 of these. See that? Let's grab it. If 2 underworlds knock out the Hawks. I don't have 2 underworld suits. I'll just grab this. I'm just grabbing resources. I'm just hoarding resources at this point. I don't know what to tell you. Because like I said, my logic is I'm not going to get any more in the next round, so I might as well grab them now. Alright. We need at least one attacker, though. We're not gonna be able to conquer anything. Yeah. He's gonna steal two cities and get the points for that. Alright. Eastern trade, so I can get another one of these. But that probably sounds like a bad idea. Because I already have so many. That means I get more taxes, so. I need something to absorb damage, though. This will absorb damage. I guess that's okay. Gain for every ranged attacker. There are no ranged attackers on the enemy's side. And he's not going to grab one this turn either, so that one's not going to give me a bonus. So how much culture do I get? I get 5 culture, and he will get 2, so that's okay. I'll take the hit there. But he's going to get 2 points for the conquest move because he has 2 attackers, and I have none. So I can pay a tax on that. For a permanent resource, that's fine. I'll pay a one-time tax on that. Get the income and the resources. So I'll take that. Okay, so conquer mode means he's going to get 2 points over here. Because I don't have any attackers. See? Actually, he has 3 attackers. Yes, he'll get a bunch more points. So he'll get 3, 2, 1. Okay, remember. That's the first one. That's the first city you conquer. That's worth 3. That's the second city you conquer, that's worth 2. That's the first city you conquer, that's worth 1. I believe that's how that works. So, the order in which you pull your attacker card seems to matter. Someone has to absorb the 3. I'm gonna take a hit. I don't want to lose culture. Okay, so I can lose some of these duplicates. Like these right here, these are duplicates. So I can afford to lose this one, because I'll still have, because I have, see, I have 2 crafts and 2 stones. So if I drop one of these, I'm going to lose it, but at least I'll get to keep the bonus. Okay, so I have to absorb the 2. So I'll absorb the 2 from here, and absorb the 2 from here, and it will still be alive and will not get knocked out. So that's good. Yeah. And one of these cards, and half of these cards will be available in the next round anyway, so I'm still alive. Score, 4-1, and he gets 2 culture. Okay, so I get gold for that one, and I lose the knockout card, so that one's now ruined. Other knockout cards, I have no more knockout cards, so we're good. Okay, next round. He has more points than I do, but I can catch up, I think. Rams Saints game coming on pretty soon, so I'll be able to finish this game before it gets too late. And I think I'm really digging this game, so I'm glad I got to spend some time with it. It's like Civilization with cards. That's right up my, that's literally my alley. Like, it's not even an alley, it's like a boulevard for me. I need to play more card games. Temple of Wisdom. I don't have 3 of these, so it's not gonna happen. But that's a lot of culture to get right away. And I, no taxes, but I gotta pay a tax on that, though. It's a one-time tax. With 1 infantry, knock out 1. So I can knock out that one. So maybe I can make a run for this one, because I get culture and attack. So that might be worth it. I'll pay the tax, but it's just 1 gold. I'm fine with that. And he pays a tax to me, so I get my gold back. I'm not complaining. So I got some resources he doesn't have. See, like right down here, I have this. Even though I lost one of my stone resources during the attack, I still had another one. So the duplicate resource worked. Like right here, I have 2 iron resources. So I can afford to lose one in an attack. Like I can afford to lose this one in an attack. But I'm going to have another one left. So that was a good sacrifice, I think, on my part. He gets discounts for those, but he has to pay a tax if he chooses this one. But he'll get culture, but he'll have to pay me a coin for that. So we'll see how that goes. But remember, you get a point for 2 coins, so might be worth it after all. At the end of the game, anyway. Okay, I got culture for this, and I got culture for this. The next one's free, but I might not need the money. This is going to be incredibly handy for fending off attacks, I think. So I'll just grab this one. So that might be better than just getting... So the discounts I get from all these blue things right here might... might eliminate the need for me to get free items. See, I got discounts for that and that, but I'm gonna have to pay a tax if I buy one of these. But I get discounts right off the bat for this. One ally can't be knocked out or ruined. That sounds good, actually. I have one attacker. He has three, so I'm gonna need at least one attacker. See, where's my first attacker is here, and he's going up against this guy, so that's a tie. I don't know who wins a tie. The second attacker is gonna lose. So, but the idea is if I pick one, I think I'll be fine. I want to at least win 1 point for the conquest. I get culture for this. Heal all damage to one at the end of round. And I have one of these. All allied gain two of those. Wow. Imagine this getting. Wow. They're worth the same. This one can absorb more damage though. Heal all damage at the end of one. Yeah, but there's no chance. But there are still two more rounds left to go in the game. But there's no guarantee that I'm going to be able to pull this card in the next two rounds. So, though it looks like a very good card, though. So, how about that? One ally can't be knocked out or ruined, but I might not need it. But we'll see it. Because I have this. So I don't have to worry about anyone getting knocked out, because this will absorb most of the damage. But this one's running low, so we'll see how it goes. Let me grab another attacker. So they'll give me an extra point in the conquest mode. See, he pays attacks to me. He's getting some more culture. I'm probably gonna need some culture here. But I have two attackers, he has three. So this guy got knocked out. Okay, so I guess, yeah, he can't do anything, okay. So his first attacker will be here, my first attacker will be here. So he'll win. Then the next round he'll win, and then I'll get the third city. Fine, I accept that. Okay, so he goes first. And then I win. So I'm going to get at least one city, that's fine. So let me get some culture here. That's my logic anyway. I believe that's the order of attacking. Let me get my DVD turned on. Okay. Skirmisher, jewel mine. How about a jewel mine? I like to get all that money. I get culture, so I guess it's worth it. I'll grab it. So I get money and culture. Swap culture with enemy bot at the same time. So I could have grabbed that. So I could have grabbed this three, but I never know what he's going to grab, see? I win the first, he gets the second, and he gets the third. So I grabbed one city, but I grabbed the biggest city. So that was good for me, I think. The first city you grab is the biggest, so I'm glad I grabbed that. I don't know how that worked exactly, but I won. Yeah, I had a six. Actually, no, I didn't. Yeah, how did the order work? I don't know how the order worked there. Well, I'll check anyway. I need someone to absorb the five. So that means I can get my Cyclopean walls up there to absorb the five. I don't want him to get wiped out, because I don't want to lose the culture. Okay, what am I going to lose here? I'm going to lose a horse. Yeah, what do I want to lose? Well, is he going to get to attack? Well, I still have my six. See, I got the six down here, so maybe I still get a chance. Nope, it got wiped out. Oh, never mind. Okay, never mind. So he still managed to take them out. He still managed to take out the Holy Knights down here. So, okay. So he still got a chance to do his attack, even though he got knocked out. But that's fine. I don't feel so bad about that, okay. So I get money. One knocked out card is ruined, and that's that one. So I can't use that anymore. He lost his Underworld Swift Assassin, but that's fine because it's just a culture sink, I believe. It steals culture. I didn't get any points. I didn't get any culture for that, huh? But look at this. I got way more money than he does, but he's got way more culture than I do. Okay, this is not going to go well. Alright. So what do I want next? I definitely want culture, because I need to catch up there. I have no attackers. I got three culture. He has two culture to start. Okay, has for each enemy attacker. He has three attackers, so I can just grab culture right off the bat with this one. So I think this one's definitely going to move. My opponent had this card in the last match. So this was incredibly handy for him, I think. So I'm definitely going to grab that. I think that might have closed the gap. So he's going to grab culture there. And see, I'm going to grab all of this. See that? Because he has three attackers, so I'm going to grab all these buffs. That was definitely worth it. And I get more armor. See? How great is that? And I get all these culture bonuses. So the tooltips here are very handy, so I'm glad they included those. Okay, let's get at least one attacker. But, yeah, my first attacker is going to be the city guard. So I think it's entirely possible I'm going to lose the 3-point bonus here. Let's at least grab this. So I get a lot of culture. I don't want to give up all that culture. Ooh, I don't want to give up all that culture. That's a lot of culture. Let me at least grab this because I'll get one fortified gains culture. I don't have a mounted horse. Gosh darn it, not a mounted horse. Well, this one has too many taxes attached to it anyway. Well played. Okay, so this one has a bunch of discounts. No taxes here, no taxes. These are worth the same. This one's better off for defending. This one gives me more. This one's just better. Because I don't have any mounted cards here. So I don't want to risk it. So he gains one for he gains culture for each allied holy city. I get a bunch of discounts. There's a tax on these two. So I don't want to grab those if I don't have to. But it's only one coin. It's not a big deal. Okay, so I can grab more resources. I thought I wasn't supposed to get any more of these. Penultimate round. I'm not going to grab that. But do I have another underworld? No, I don't. Okay, so this can just absorb damage. That's fine. So I want this, or I want a bunch of culture. I think I want a bunch of culture. Because I don't think I need any more resources, really. Because I already, well, I can get more gems. And I can get wood. You don't have any wood. He has wood, so I have to pay taxes on wood. So basically, this would eliminate any taxes I would have to pay for the next two turns. But look at all that culture. Oh, look at this. It's so juicy. I'll take that. Okay, I'll grab that. Rams scored a touchdown. Sean McVay on point. Okay. That's going to be a fun game, I think. Two teams score a lot of points. All right. I need an attacker. I only have one attacker. We have three down here. Plus four attack versus that before the war. Okay. That might be worth it. I'll give me six attack. Alright, reduce all enemy war damage by one for each house. Well, I have one house up here, but that's only a drop of one. That's not like a big deal. But it might allow me to keep some of these open. Yeah, because this guy has a five. So I might have to drop him down to four so that well, this thing can absorb a bunch of damage. 5, 8, 10. So we can absorb 8. And the Northern Raids can take the rest. Okay, I understand. So it's starting to make sense now. Block next enemy placed after scouts. Well, I haven't figured out the order about how this works. Plus four attack versus spearmen before the war. Assuming that matters. I'll just grab this and the culture. I have to pay the gem tax, but that's not bad. That's not awful. I haven't figured out why there are only three cards this turn instead of four. Maybe there are only four cards in the first turn. Look at all this money I got. So look at that. So this guy picked up another attacker, so I get a buff up here. Here come the buffs. Wow. Okay, this is going to be interesting. Conquer mode. So I only have one attacker. I'm not going to get any of this. Yep. So why is my two all the way up here? Is it in reverse order? Yeah, I think it's in reverse order. Yeah, 5, 4, 7. Yeah, I think it might be in reverse order. Okay. Okay, so they dropped a bunch of damage, but they got that buff up there, so ugh, that hurt. I need to grab a 6. I don't want to split the damage, so I could split the damage. I don't want to lose that culture. Okay. So what do I want to absorb this? That'll split the damage to 3, I think. Okay, someone needs to absorb this 6. So that'll be fine. Someone has to absorb the 4. That could be here. Someone has to absorb... So I'm getting rid of that, and I don't care. It's a worthless card. It's just an empty card, anyway. Okay, someone needs to absorb the 4. That could be this one. And someone could absorb the 3. So you can absorb the 4. They could. Let me just... Yeah. Absorb the 4. And then this can absorb the 3. And then we'll be fine. So we get all that culture. We're fine, don't worry. I don't know how this is going to go in the final round. That's the part I haven't figured out yet. But look at all this culture. Look at that. What are we up to? It's a tie? Ooh, but I got more money, see? I got 28, he's got 9. So I'm going to get 14 more culture. And he's going to get 4 more. So remember, you get a point for every 2 gold pieces. So this might work out in my favor. And the Eagles just won. They don't have another game coming up after this, do they? Nope. So that's it. So it's all Rams-Saints now. And this game is on CBS, which makes no sense because CBS usually airs road NFC road games, and the Saints are a road team. So why are they playing on CBS? This happens every once in a while. It's kind of funky. Because every time you think you understand the rules for broadcasting, it just doesn't work. Okay, I got to pay a tax on this and a tax on this. This one's no tax, and I get culture for that. Okay, so I get a lot of culture for this. I get so much culture for this. I gotta grab it. It's too much culture to just. I get too much culture to just leave by itself. So I'm glad I grabbed this card earlier because it means I get a chance to grab those bonuses again. Definitely, I want all that culture. Okay, so I get resources here. But in this case, I get 2 resources and extra armor, so I want to grab that. I have plenty of gold to pay for this, so this will not be a problem. I had to pay a tax on that, but it's only 1 gold. Okay, see, taxes on all of these. I'm going to have to pay a tax no matter what. I'm going to get extra gold at the end of the round. I could get 2 gold or 6. If I get 6, then I get 3 extra points right here. Because remember, I get a point for every 2 gold pieces. Okay, I get culture, and I get money. Reduce all enemy war damage by 1. I have to figure out if I keep forgetting if I get. I keep forgetting if there's a war this part of the game. I keep forgetting. Okay, he paid a tax to me. I paid a tax to him. It all works out. So I got way more money than he does. So I get discounts for these. Yep, no taxes. That's a worthless car, but it's free. But I have so much money. So I don't need to worry about free cars. I have so much money. All right. So all those resources work because they give me discounts, so these free cards don't matter. I have to remember not to tap the... I do not want to tap this trackpad until I pick the card I want. So it's a good thing I have this empty card right here, I guess. This one has way more culture, so it's definitely worth it. I'm not going to get 3 holy sites, though. I'm pretty certain of that. So that bonus isn't going to be meaningful to me at all. Okay, I got a worthless card over there. 4 discounts. Wow, this card got a lot cheaper. Gain culture and armor for every enemy attacker. He has 3. So I'm definitely going to get another bonus on this. This is an awesome card. I'm so glad I got this one. See, look at this. So 3 attackers down there. They're highlighted in blue. And I get all these buffs and all the culture. So this is definitely going to help me out. This guy has 8 culture down there. I have 13 up here. So it looks like we might come out ahead, depending on what gets killed. I can get another holy site for a +2. Yeah, I'll take this culture. So I get 4 culture. If I can grab another holy site, then I'll have a triple. So I'll get a bonus for that and a bonus for this. If I can get 1 more holy site, I'm gonna guarantee, it's a guaranteed win, as far as I'm concerned. Okay, so I need someone to absorb this damage. I got culture and armor here. I have to pay a tax on that. This is free, so I'll take this culture and the armor. Sop up damage from one of these spearmen, probably. And I get an extra buff, because he grabbed another attacker. And I didn't get another holy, so I won't be able to get this triple holy bonus because I only have 2 holy cards. If I was able to grab a 3rd holy card, then I would get bonuses to my culture and it would have been a guaranteed win. That's okay. I'm starting to learn all the synergies of this game now, so. So I told you, this game has a lot of meat on its bones. I'm becoming more impressed the more I play with it. It's only been an hour and a half, but I'm starting to really dig it. City guard. So I get culture here, and I can attack. Do I have any attackers? I don't have any attackers. I might as well grab this one, so I get the attack bonus. So I have to keep track of do I get conquer and war mode here in the final round. Here we go. Okay, so there's a conquer mode. So it's in reverse order. Five, no, it's not in reverse order. 5, 3, 3, 2. How is the order determined? It might be random. So I didn't get a single city. That's okay. So I have to absorb the five. Who absorbs the five? I gotta keep my culture though. So that could absorb the five. So I'll lose the income on that, I think. Well, that won't matter. I think I already got the income from that. Who absorbs the three? He'll still be alive after that. So that can absorb the three. Who absorbs the three here? And they can absorb the two. So we get all our money back? Did we get healed? No, we did. Okay. So we got all our money back. Fully heal a spearman after the war, but it won't matter because the game is about to end. So look at all this culture I'm going to get. Look at that. 76. We're going to win. Yes! So I have more money, so I'm going to win. I'm going to win. Outstanding. Did it again. Was that hard mode? So resources worked. They made everything cheaper, so I had more gold at the end of the game. Of course, they made everything cheaper. They gave me extra income streams at the beginning of every round. So the money's piled up, and I was able to come up with more money at the end of the game, which gave me more points at the end of the game. So the conquest points, yeah, he destroyed me in conquest points. But as it turns out, conquest points are not nearly as meaningful as culture points and gold. At least the way I played. It was an overwhelming cultural victory. So that worked out. We spent about the same amount of gold. He actually got more discounts than I did. So why did I get so much more money? But what matters is that I had so many more culture points. So the money that I spent went towards items that had more culture attached to them, like this right here and this right here. So it was definitely worth it. I don't know how much these cards are worth, but they probably came with massive discounts. So waste generated. No waste generated. So that was a pretty good run, all things considered. Okay, I'll grab whatever. Go 50. Okay, never mind. That was the worst card I could have pulled. That's okay. The other ones are more rare anyway. So I won two games as Ziana, and I won a game against a hard computer. So I'll claim my money. And I will claim my Orphan Queen reward. Theophilus is unlocked. Okay, so now what? I can't do these because I can only play against the computer because I'm not online. Fine. Complete five games in any mode. Okay, that's fine. Win three games as Kubra. Yo, Joe. So we'll replace that. I can win two games by buying archers. Okay. Maybe I'll come around to an archer at some point. So I can't cancel any more missions today. Maybe tomorrow. But we're doing okay, huh? Cards. Primary resource, iron. That's up here, yep. See, they got the tooltips on all the screens. That's kind of handy. And I get discounts if I have these resources. So I get a discount on wood. Okay, so it makes sense to buy certain resources early on. And we get a double discount for having iron. So if we have one iron resource, we get a double discount for Leviathan. So stuff like that, okay. See, that's good to know. Gladiators aren't available yet. We'll get there. What are these? Middle card draws. Oh! Look at that. Hold on. Let's see. This draws anytime. So it draws anytime. That's what these three stars mean. Draws in round one and no later. Okay. This one is a middle card. Draws in late in round one or anytime after. Okay. Huh. And what's this? Draws in round three. Okay. this game has so many wrinkles. So many friggin' wrinkles. Okay, scouts. Underworld. Okay, this is starting to get... Where are the economic ones? Gems. These come early. What comes late? Eastern trade comes late in round one or later, okay. So now it's starting to make sense. Tax collectors. Okay. Okay, I think I get it. So some resources you want to grab early, but you might get a discount. But if it only draws in round one, and that means you might want to grab this sooner rather than later. In fact, what do I get for that? Yeah, where's the training? Yeah, so I can grab that first, and I get a bonus for stones. If I grab stone first, I'll get a discount on this. But it's only worth 2 gold. So it's not much of a discount. Okay. See, this game's starting to make sense. Empire. Yeah, we'll come back later. Coins. I can't buy any cards, can I? Let me go back down a bit, see what's locked. Yeah, right here. So I have to get a card pack. So how do I get a card pack? Down here. Spend 100 to buy a card pack? Sure. Bought a card pack. What did I get? Let's see how much knowledge I can gain now. So I get culture for that, and some pretty good defense. Gives me, there are discounts associated with stone and horses. It's worth 7, so I can probably drop this down to 4, or 3, excuse me, 3 gold. I don't really like these underworld cards, but with house enemy attacks its ally. Wow. Handy. Yeah, we are unboxing, kids. This is officially an unboxing video. Artificer. Duplicate previous ally. Is replaced with another copy of the last card you drafted. I guess that's useful. The Pyramid of Ages looks really handy, though. Okay, so we'll end the video. See, I'm digging this.